of you, Colonel Sanders, a finger-licking goods dating simulator. Now, I do not know why I decided, hey, my first gaming video is going to be this game. Maybe I'm just weird like that, but whatever. But right now, I'm going to lower this volume. And, the volume of the game, So, people can hear me. But, alright, so, now, I hope y'all like the start of this new weird game. I don't know what this is about. I can't wait to get into it. But right now, let's drop in. Welcome, chef. Before we get started, tell us your name. My name, call me, wait, there's no lowercase? Okay, this is all caps. My name is Akuta. Oh God. I don't even know what I'm getting myself into. Oh, it's already starting. You sleep softly at the morning sun. Cats cast a warm glow through the window. Your modest student apartment. I can't really read. I need to go back to school? Question mark? So this is my room? Crazy! I mean, I guess it looks pretty cool. The world is peaceful and searing. Oh, I don't even know that word. You could stay in the moment forever. Well, that depends because, Jesus Christ. You could wake up now. Your first day of elementary school, there's no time to sleep. Okay. Smack the clock. Okay, stop that noise. Lying in bed, you stare at the ceiling, thinking about everything that awaits you at the prestigious University of Cooking School, Academy for Learning. Well, you know what they say. It's time to bake. I hate myself. All right, continue. Your mind begins to wander. Who will be there? What will you cook? What should you wear? Time begins to fly by, and you find your imagination getting away from you. You'll need to take this seriously, allow yourself to daydream a bit, think about the future. I think we should take this seriously, you know what I'm saying? Because we don't want us, to be failing. So we might as well take this seriously. Oh, this is me. I'd better make sure to arrive prepared from the first day. First day. Crazy. You bust through your morning checklist. Teeth, brush, hair, comb. I don't comb my hair. This is a lie. Pits, deodorize. Yeah, you definitely need those deodorize. Nothing can stop you now. There you go. The confidence. You confidently grab a biscuit, struck out the door, and head off to class. What is this? Every anime? That eating sound. Just wait. Just what you need to get your blood flowing. This game is freaking weird. Standing in the quad, you gaze upon the magnificent University of Cooking School Academy for Learning. Here comes your lifelong best friend forever, Mirror Man. Oh, you get a best friend? Just like every anime? Okay. Oh. She's the most adorably awkward person you ever met. And you absolutely love her for it. Okay.
Good morning, Akuta. Are you excited for the first day of the rest of our lives?
Rest of our lives? What you talking about? I'm trying to go and have my days. Crazy.
Actually, because I sure am excited. A little nervous. Okay. A lot nervous. It's just that this morning, I made breakfast for myself. But, well, when I ate it, I couldn't taste any love in the food. What if I'm no good? What if I fail?
Aww, he's crying. Can I cheer up?
Classic Miami.
Miriam? How do you say her name? God damn it.
Raised by MasterChef parents, she's always held herself to a very high standard.
Wow. Sounds like a certain friend I know.
Ever since we were little babies playing together, you rescued me from that quicksand box. It's been clear to me that you're the most loving, caring person I know. You're going to do great.
Oh shit.
But with university cooking school, academy for learning, famous three day only semesters, I'm afraid of being left behind and never catching up.
A sweet girl, Miriam has always had a flair for the dramatic. This summer, she got so nervous about her first kiss that she chipped a tooth practicing on a manicure. What the fuck?
What the heck?
Oh, she kissing? Oh, that's crazy. Should you pep talk her or change the subject to give her some relief?
Pep talk, change the subject to school gossip.
I'm gonna be a good friend and talk to her about it, you know?
Damn.
Remember last month when we saw that fortune teller and had our tarot cards reviewed? The lady with the mask who gave me nightmares, I've been trying to forget. I know she looked spooky, but she was so sweet, and she told you that you were destined for great things. Remember that card with the fancy looking tower, and that other card featuring the handsome fellow in the red suit?
I've been waiting for so long to meet a handsome fellow I could call my own.
I mean, I guess I'm not handsome.
And I'm sure you'll will soon. In no time you'll be graduating, and you'll be delighting the world with your heartfelt cooking in no time at all.
Oh, okay. I just realized something. Is this our outfits? Okay. What season is this? Is this summer? Wait, that's not summer, but. Well, since it's the first day, it'll be the fall? Okay, so I get it. Okay. Step up the fall, then.
As you talk Miriam up, you can feel her nerves begin to ease.
Crazy!
You know what? Maybe everything will be okay after all. And if not, at least I have these killer bangs?
The heck's a killer bangs? You got a gun?
Crazy! Can you believe I can cut them myself?
You can definitely believe it. I cannot believe it. Before you can get another word out, you're really interrupting when someone smacks your books in a custom Eve yard, measuring spoons out of your hands and onto the ground. Wait, what?
Hey!
It's Ashila, your arch rival. She's totally evil, but you can't help but be filled with jealousy. She can get anything she wants, and she knows it.
Man!
I hate this girl already. I'm joking.
Hello, Ashila.
I'm gonna call her Leaf. I should call her. You know what? A certain character I know. I'm gonna call her Violet. Unless there's a Violet in this game.
Oh, I didn't see you there, chicken shins.
I should slap the goofy out you.
You leave Akuta shins alone. They are perfectly normal shins.
Well, I appreciate your effort. you know?
Ugh. You can't stand Violet.
Even her name is annoying. You know for a fact that she is actually, that is actually Ashley. Oh, it's Ashley. Okay, let's call her Ashley. But she had to add extra letters to make herself better than everyone. For one with big watermelons and pretty... I'm not going to finish that sentence. If anyone here knows
what perfect shins look like, it's us.
You tell her.
Yeah, I like Miri. I'm going to call her Miri. I like Miri. You know, she's that good friend.
We're not going to let you on your weird insults to get us.
There you go, me. Stand up for yourself. Across the quad, you see Ashley's best friend, Van, the man. I hate this. Has stopped to look at his own reflection in the mirror. His pants are so tight, you can see him casually working out his glutes.
While he styles his hair, no lie, they're
rocking glutes.
Why am I thinking this? Am I gay? Crazy!
Ahem, Van?
You rang. Oh my god. I hate it. You've never been sure what their arrangement is, but as long as you've known them, Ashley and Van have been just as close as you and Miriam is as Miri, but substantially more devious.
Look at her face.
Man, stop sucking your teeth.
Is that Joestar, but black?
Okay. I can't believe that the University Cooking School Academy for Learning would ever allow people like you to attend as students.
That's a fact.
Ashley.
I know, right? You think they just hand us diplomas now.
Shut up!
Or maybe hire us as professors. You amateurs could learn a lot from us. When the first day of school about to start, there's just no time to properly tell these two off, so you resist the urge.
Let's go, Miriam.
Yeah, we should go.
See you later, losers.
Wow, you are a very confident one. As you approach, I love the sound effects. Oh my god, stop. As you see a goofy looking kid push his heart against the window.
Did he fart?
Oh wait, no, that was just noise. Whoops. Pop.
Oops. Oopsie. I think it's broken.
You reach forward and easily pull the door open.
That should do the trick.
I love you.
I think you mean thank you?
My name is Pop. I was named after my Pop. He's old.
Could someone like this also be a student at the school? He must be one heck of a chef. About also his name tag clearly says Bob. Very original name, but I guess he's reading upside down.
Hi Pop, I'm Akuta. So
are you gonna make me hold the door all day?
Nope.
And with that, the young man walks into the building ahead of you.
Is it just me, or is he kind of, cute?
I think it's just you.
Yep.
You both shrug your shoulders before following him into the building. You stand in the edge.
What is this? Oh my, is that chicken wing on the board? We learning chicken wing on math? Crazy.
You stand at the edge of the room, unsure where to sit. The other students wander in and keep themselves busy chit-chatting.
Ow, my ears.
A scuffy pooch takes his place at the podium in front of the class.
Adorable.
What voice should I give? Sprinkles?
Oh my god, I love this game.
What voice should I give him? I think I got one.
Quiet down. Everyone.
Who is this unreasonably cute pup? And why is he in our culinary class?
That's a good question.
You must be Sprinkles. Head instructor and CEO of UCSAL.
It's a UCSAL.
Okay.
Aww.
Please, call me Professor Dog. I may be cute, but in a little fluffy. But I still demand respect, woof.
What? A cute dog is our professor?
This is the best school ever!
I guess only a dog's nose is capable of picking up all nuisances and for a fine dying.
That is true. Yeah, man, this is the best school ever, bro. A dog?
Crazy. Why is your petals? Out of nowhere, wind begins to rush around you, and a swirl of cherry blossom petals fill the air inside the classroom, like every anime moment we will see.
I'm chilly. Someone close the window.
And then he walks in.
Oh my god. He is hot. I'm just going, no homo.
You are immediately swept up in the aura of this new student. And his remarkable goatee, who knew anyone could be so handsome. Time stands still.
What's the actual? Oh my god.
It's him.
If it isn't my favorite student, Harlan.
Colonel Sanders interrupts Sprinkles. Sorry. Professor Dodd, before he finished his sentence.
Please,
call me Colonel. I'll call you Colonel. Yeah, sure, Colonel. Colonel Sanders. Jesus Christ, I hate this.
A hushed murmur rolls through the classroom as Colonel Sanders walks down a style of desks. Suddenly the room is sweaterling?
Whatever. Sweat begins to bead across the brow. You feel like everyone is looking at you, and you're not entirely wrong.
Is that her voice?
Whatever.
Isn't it? This over here must be Sweetie Sweets a lot.
Aha!
Maybe we should open that window back up before first it pits melts into a puddle of and evaporates entirely.
Is he talking about me?
Hold on a second. No one talks about my friend like that.
Oh, he's talking about me. Oh, she's talking about me.
Boy, I'll cut up them cheeks.
Crazy.
Oh, well, thank you. You look like you're going Super Saiyan.
Oh, she's going Super Saiyan.
You two both know my name. We were in the
same kindergarten class. And what is all your really What is with all your really weird insults?
That's true.
Besides, when Akuta sweats, it's not gross. It's beautiful. Look at that shimmer. Huh?
Are you good?
Thanks, I guess.
You take a moment to clean yourself up. Oh, I guess I pick it. Okay.
It's a good thing you didn't forget about that deodorant this morning. This classroom is hot, hot, hot.
Dang, cannot wear my short sleeves. Crazy.
... Professor Dog steps into a settled classroom and sets down some ground rules. Of course, every teacher would.
Welcome to University Cooking School, Academy for Learning, the greatest culinary academy in the world.
Really?
The birthplace of culinary legends past, present, and future. Many challenges await you. There will be tears. There will be blood.
Blood?
What? I'm scared. There might even really be adorable tiny food.
Is anyone gonna question what he said, blood?
When this is all done, there will be a battle. You will lift your spokes and compete in the broom cooking arena.
Why is he so angry? Damn.
Just then, another student enters the classroom and interrupts the professor's rousing speech.
Wow. So interesting. Hi guys, I'm late.
I hope everyone had a good summer. I really miss...
Quiet!
Late to class is bad enough, but interrupting my monologue?
You're on the fast track out of here. Out of here, young man.
Are you sure you're leaving in the last place?
Don't you recognize me?
This is my third year in this school. With you as my teacher.
Everyone stares at him blankly.
Does no one remember me?
Oh wow, he's getting the no one remembers him treatment.
I know how it feels, bro. I know how it feels.
You're expelled if you utter one more word before I finish.
Dang! Expulsion? Expelled? Crazy!
Let that be a lesson to you, students. That tardiness is unacceptable! Even Clank made it a weird one time, rolling halfway across town on his tiny wheels.
You turn to see the student Sprinkles is referencing, who appears to be some sort of industrial kitchen appliance? The class bursts into laughter.
Okay, so I'm supposed to laugh now?
Ha ha, funny joke.
Oh,
Clank, so rascal, you rascal.
Sprinkles walks in the classroom as everyone stands in silent obedience.
Crazy!
When he gets to you, he lifts his nose into the air and takes a deep sniff.
Are you good?
I mean, he is a dog.
Your diet is lacking based on what I'm picking up here. You're definitely a multivitamin. You should be taking better care of yourself. Excuse me?
Okay. You know what? I should slap you.
You've never had a talking dog before. You never had a talking dog as a teacher before. But Sprinkle's reputation for being smart but tough is well known. You decide to try to butter him up by giving him a treat from your pocket. But what kind?
Beef treat, a rubber ball, or a chicken snack. Let's not be offensive. So let's give him a chicken. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
You reach beneath your apron and return with a chicken snack on your hand. Sprinkle's eyes go wide and locks onto it as he walks onto it. His favorite.
Yes, I got it right. See, let's not be offensive. See, I knew it.
Well, 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 well. I think there might be some competition for New Star Student.
Let's go!
Let's go!
The furry professor immediately devours the snack, leaving your hands slick with coating of warm doggy drool.
Ew. Nasty.
I'm gonna wash my hands.
You see the other students eyeing you jealously, but paid no mind to them. If they wanted to succeed in life, they should have learned the importance of carrying a range of dog treat flavors on them at all times.
Yup, your boy is smart.
Settle down, young chefs. Take your seats. Take your seats and prepare to take your minds open to amazing possibilities of culinary creation.
As everyone rushes to their favorite seats, you're left standing in the front of the room, but only two options remain.
Hey, Akuta, there's a seat here.
It seems that no one has claimed a seat next to me, if you're interested. The two options you choose. I will sit. You know, I'll sit with my best friend. You know, she's been really supportive. I'm gonna sit with her. You move to your seat by Miri.
I'm so glad you're
near me to support me through this class.
Of course. You're my best friend. Who else would I sit by?
Colonel Sanders. He's such a magnificent magnet personality. And there's a seat open right next to him. If you had sat there, you might have gotten to know him a little better.
Nah, listen, important people, bruh. No, sometimes people can be overrated, you know? I'd never sacrifice our friendship.
Besides, I'm sure I'll get a chance to talk to him later in the semester. I got 3 whole days. That's a lifetime.
So you say, but now Miri mentions it, that Colonel Sanders is just so darn dreamy. As soon as you settle into your seat, the professor makes an announcement.
Shadow the Hedgehog is a... Okay, some stuff.
Think fast. It's time for a pop quiz.
Oh god, pop quizzes.
Yay, a quiz about me.
Funny.
This incredibly important and surprisingly short quiz will tell me if you are ready for life at culinary school. Keep your knives sharp and your focus sharp. Here comes question 1.
If a train traveling to point B and train is traveling to point A, how important is your wash your hands before cooking?
It depends.
Okay, if you think about it.
I would say, oh god, let's do this.
That's right.
Forest is to tree as chicken is to
feather?
That's right. Okay. Wow.
What kind of most efficient eating utensil ever created? I want to say... That's wrong. Damn it. What food is best for a broken heart? Anything as long as you prepare it not too much. Smoke. Okay. Wow. Is Sprinkles a good boy? He's a talking dog that teaches good. He's the best boy. Yeah. Your score is... Total score, 4 out of 10. Okay, let's go. Only one wrong. Not too shabby. You might just do all right, kid. All right, let's go. Smart boy in class. You look up to Colonel Sanders. He's been watching you tally your score. He nods with approval. I may have your attention, students. I have an important announcement to make. Okay. Time for lunch. Yes. Wow, the cafeteria is nice and as any you never eat. Never even ate in that. It makes sense that a school dedicated to cooking would also be serious about eating. Okay, so we're gonna do this part a bit and then I'm gonna end it. Okay. A delicious fragrance wafts through the room and tickles the end of your nose. Your mouth waters.
Do you smell that? That must be our lunch. It smells crazy good. Everyone, can I have your attention? Is it about lunch?
No, it's a... I want you to apologize for my tardiness. You see, I was...
Howdy, folks. I'd like to make an announcement.
Hey, I was...
It's about lunch.
Oh, come on. Don't interrupt him like that. Everyone cheers.
But I...
Aw, come on, don't be mean to the kid.
Lunch, lunch, lunch. She said, shh.
In honor to the new semester, I have prepared something special to share with everyone for lunch.
Aha! That must be the smell I smelled.
Indeed, that smell. You hold your breath waiting to see what food and mysterious created you've heard that he's very talented, but where the room is true. Is this? Colonel Sanders has a large bucket above his head. Contents glimmer in the light.
Oh, I could get some food KFC right now.
Piled high pieces of chicken, huge pieces of chicken, breaded fried crispy golden finish. And Ramones envelops you and beginning to warm and safe. Colonel Sanders has filled a bucket with chicken. What a novel concept. Your stomach begins to grumble as if you're thinking,
stop thinking and start eating.
For years, I've been developing a secret recipe for the perfect fried chicken. But my calculation, nothing less than 11 herbs and spices are required to achieve that perfect balance of flavors. You look around to notice every student has a pen and paper as it's taking notes and is scribbling notes as fast as it can. Wow. But that's all I can say about it.
What?
What do you think your stupid secret ingredient do? Sure. Nah, my dude.
I'm just a drafting book, a testament. In case one of those ingredients is a poison.
Got him.
He looks around nervously as everyone is laughing at his sick burn. He waits to see that zinger Ashley has prepared to follow up, but she suddenly takes a different approach.
Yeah, it was just like writing in my diary. Dear diary.
Oh, hold on. Bless me.
Dear diary, I totally smelled something beautiful. I knew at the moment that I only had my hands on the true definitely could
fried chicken so tender. You see her body language change, bitter and evil to sweet innocent as she slides into Colonel Sanders. Closer to Colonel Sanders, she realizes that he is destined for greatness and fame. His cooking skills, like this, she wants to alter herself.
Gold diggers these days.
Oh, please.
Well, Van the Man Man, if you don't want any,
I'll take his.
Whoa, hold on. I guess I'll try it. He takes one bite and overgrown wide. He starts confronting his face. He tries to hold a pure exhilaration and acts unimpressed. Easy now. There's enough for everyone, please. My fellow guest classmates, dig in. Take one piece of chicken out of the bucket and sink your teeth into it.
It's amazing.
What is this?
Tasting Colonel Sanders' food transports into another dimension? Alone, the taste buds gripping your dumbstruck, you float witlessly.
Hey, bro, I'm swimming towards that light.
Somewhere up ahead, brings bonds to you. The fairies are too insane with you wrapped around in them, unable to exist. You reach toward the light in your hands closer and closer. Your fingertips connects with the very end of every wage. You are forever land of the tender fried chicken bliss. Your mind devolves. As there's no Akuta now, there's only herbs and spices. Do Miriam mind to revive you? She cannot. Treasure.
Wait, I failed? Oh, wait, I failed? Wait, what? Wait, I fail at the game? Am I not supposed to do that? Did I die? Oh my god. What? The heck? What? So you just... Oh my god, I don't get this game. So we're not gonna move towards the light, I guess. This is weird.
Oh, okay, so we're back here. Okay, so I'm not gonna continue now, but next episode, we will continue on this, and now I know to not click, move towards the light. So... resume the title screen. Okay, so that was the first time playing this game. I feel like, for a game like this is really, really odd. Like, this is such an odd game. But I definitely recommend it to some people if they want a weird adventure. Whatever. But the thing is, I'll see y'all next time. And have a nice day. Bye.